It needed a reboot. Thank you, everybody, for coming. Without you, there wouldn't have been a conference. And without you, we wouldn't have learned how to make a conference. This being a school, and in the nature of the school, we can consider ourselves students. We don't know if this is like our graduation, but maybe we graduate as conference organizers after this. We also feel a little bit sad that we have to end it now, because on the final day, everything is just running so smoothly. And thanks everyone also for making it run smoothly, not least the venue. Thanks to all 377 attendees that we counted. And thanks to everyone who put in a submission to make this conference have such rich content. Without so many submissions, it wouldn't have been possible for the content team to make such an amazing selection. But also a big, big thank you to all others who submitted. Please give everyone a big hand. Also, T-shirts were printed as many as they possibly could in the print shop. They were working after hours, and they came in and put in an extra effort today to make it happen. And all in all, they managed to make 120 T-shirts, which we also think is quite fantastic. And to those of you who did not get a T-shirt, yes, it was very limited edition, and we know that some of you wanted a T-shirt but didn't get one, we'll make sure to publish the screen prints online with the permission of the ones who made them. And then you can, of course, find a way to get this T-shirt eventually.
I can say this. Well, we have had a lot of data being transferred through the air here and the wires eventually, 453 gigabytes. And that was on average 600 active clients. So think about that at home if your wireless router can manage that. More than 23 hours of recordings.
And I want to say that these recordings will, of course, be edited. Maybe some of us who have missed a lot of talks will have a certain incentive to make that happen. We'll probably sit down and try it during the sprints to edit videos. They will be published one by one for each talk. Right now, you can see all of the sessions in one go on YouTube for each day. And you can find directly right now on the YouTube channel of DjangoCon Europe.
And there was no conference without people and without sponsors. There are many things that goes into the bucket of running a conference. So money and services are definitely needed. So I'll just go through all the sponsors that have been involved with this conference and also on the weekend. So I might not pronounce all of them correctly, so but I'll just say them as best as I can. Chambon Software, these are the bronze software sponsors. ISS Hub.io, Making Media 15.5. Then we have the silver sponsors Prosa and JetBrains. Gold sponsors Nexmo, Colonial.no, and Django Stars. The diamond sponsor, Through Your Mind. Childcare sponsor, Verve, that makes sure that whoever is traveling with their children can have them looked after, at least for some time here during the conference. So that's really nice. Yeah. bathroom baskets, various utilities you need when you're going to the bathroom and around, Hibernode by Byte. And our live translation, speech to text by Django Stars and Devio. And these are real humans that are actually punching this in. This is not some AI or anything. So down here in the far left corner, the team that does the translations have been working hard for the past 3 days, so give them a big applause as well. We have, as usual, offered opportunity grants for people who are not able to participate in the conference of various reasons, but we have helped, I don't know how if we should say how many, but we have helped some to get to the conference from where they are. And thanks to these sponsors to help out with that. So that's Lincoln Loop, EuroPython Society, Python Software Foundation, the Django Software Foundation, and the Deutscher Django Verein. Yeah, I'll just go through the quickly, as I said, Lanyards, that's by Nexmo, so that's really nice. The coffee and the water, Colonial and .no and Verve. The tote bags, as you all have, and I hope you keep them and don't throw them out, because they're really nice. That's for teamwork. Do you want to say anything about the tote bags? No, they're just okay. Organic and awesome and really nice and like produced in a proper way and everything. On the weekend we will have sprints. Remember to come to the sprints. Don't stay up too late tonight. That's Verve. The Wi-Fi here to make sure that it works. Zebra Wireless. They come out and set up wireless where you need it. So they are specialists in that. Ticket Butler for the registration and all the other things around. And Mikula and their web shop, where they have a subscription where you can get the beer. Mikula is a little bit of a funny one, because they didn't do it for promotion. They did it because they love open source and they love the concept of Django. And we had some good chats about getting the logo and everything there. I hope you have enjoyed it. And the last time you will taste a Mikula beer is in not long, at least the Django Mikula beer. Sad but good.
And what started all this was that we made a small event here in Copenhagen. We call it Django Day Copenhagen, and we want to announce now that we'll have another Django Day next year. We've just figured out the date. And check out the djangocph.dk website to keep updated with the CFBP coming out and the ticket sales and so on. We hope that some of you are from Copenhagen or from other Nordic countries who would love to stop by, and we would love to hear from you, to hear about your interest in doing this.
Yeah, anyone is invited, so but it's going to be less of a scale than this. It's a one-day conference. Yeah.
And to Afuk, if any one of you are listening right now, we'll be back. We'll be back and teach you a little bit about what this Django is, we promise. Tonight there is a party, and this is the map for the party. It's not so difficult to find. It is also a map that is in your program. You can walk from here, but make sure to fill your bellies before you arrive to the party, and there's many places around in this neighborhood.
And you can get there by bus as well. So instead of this route, you catch the bus up And it's a few stops, but there is also a bus. And the entrance looks like this. We will put up one sign, but it's a little bit hard to find. But if you keep the program in the back of the program, there is this map. So and then you might find it. We will come and pick you up otherwise. It's a nice place. There are many bars if you lose us, but don't do that, please.
We are not the only ones who organize this at all. The other organizers and volunteers, can you please come up on the stage so that everyone can see you?
Hi, I'm Elvis. Some of you might have seen me going around. Together with the other guys, Sarah, for example, we were a member of the Code of Conduct team. And I mean, this is a conference from us to you, and likewise, because I mean, you are participating here as well. But we just wanted to say that we have had very small incidents. I mean, with the Code of Conduct, which means that you know it's a pleasure to have been here and know that you know we didn't have any problems, like you know people saying stuff that they shouldn't. So it's very important for us to know that we are doing something that you know for people who like to be with each other. So this is very nice and very important. And I was member of the I was invited by Benjamin and Millie to be a member of the organization team. And it was very overwhelming at the beginning because my first time at the JungleCon was last year, and I was very impressed to see the work that some of the guys that are here today did. And that was very inspiring. And that led me to join the organization team. And it was an amazing experience. So I would like to thank every single one of you for making this another great year for the JungleCon Europe. Thank you very much. And one last thing is to applaud these two guys because we are all a team, but they led the effort to make the JungleCon Europe in Copenhagen this great event that it ended up being. So, they deserve it.
Oh.